Hello, my name's Tony Watson. I'm the fire chief of Pigeon Forge. Pigeon Forge is located in East Tennessee next to the Great Smoky Mountains National Park, and this truck actually services Dollywood, and it was built for that purpose in mind, is serving that community over there because it's a 177-inch PUC body, and so we really believe it's going to be able to serve the community well. As some of y'all may be aware, is we're a multifaceted department that runs a lot of rescues, and we've set this truck up with that purpose in mind. Just starting out here on the front, the fact that we've got our tow hooks right here that we can use as a anchor point to make a difference on working off our terrain. Our terrain's very thick and very steep, so we're able to do that. We've got the winch hook up there at the front to be able to secure vehicles and be able to use for a line to be able to get out. And then one of the things unique, we've got Dolly's terrain down there, but we also have our own terrain that we respond with that you hear it when it's going through town. So this is our second PUC that we've got in position. So you do tell that we do a lot with our lighting, because tourist town, we got a lot of challenges with our traffic. So we work with those, a lot of lighting to be able to get us through, you know, that road array is good to help out. As we walk on around through here, this is a new thing that Whelan just came out with. It's very important. It will flash red, but also it'll work when we're in a dark situation. It'll light for us to be able to see for firefighter safety. So that's a huge deal right there. And I always like to talk about the Anvil Man right here. This means a lot to us right here in Pigeon Forge. This is where we started as Pigeon Forge. The Anvil Man there, it's on all of our stuff. We brand that. You know, we get 14 million visitors come through, and everybody wants to be looking at what we're doing. Inside the cab, we're really excited. This is our first apparatus that we're going to have the Haas control system to make sure that we are alerting our commuting visitors and people that they can be able to get out of the way to be able to do. First time that we went with the red interior, I'm really excited about that and what it means. We try to lay everything out for firefighter safety, so we run a lot of medical. It's about 82% of what we're doing. We run advanced life support. So one of the interesting things that we do here is that we're going to be deploying our medical stuff in here, and so we've got our chargers built all into there that we can be able to take care of our medical things that we take care of. New concept here for us in this cab layout was that we're only got two seats back there in the rear, clean cab technology. But then what we're able to do with that is that our firefighters are going to be facing forward, and we believe that that's going to give them some more situational awareness when they're pulling up. That we want thinking smart firefighters that can be able to make that difference, and they can see that fire to be able to help us when we're in that. So as we go on around, purpose build again, challenging but well worth it, is doing a lot of rescue. We got a custom Stokes, holds our Stokes basket in there for our rescue. And we use, we get the extra boxes right there because we can just do a quick relay and be able to get them back in here ready to go. So this also is something we're excited about. This is tied in so that our driver operator, if there's something going on outside, they'll have a better situational awareness, okay? So that camera is tied into right here so that they can see that. So we're excited about these new technology things that we can bring to making our firefighter safety. I can't say enough about how good it is to work with Pierce, our local Siddons-Martin dealer, and the City of Pigeon Forge for supporting us in these type of capital projects like this. Make a difference to our community that we serve. We want, in our area, I really press the fact that we're going to be neat, we're going to be organized, and we're going to be ready to work, because we have paid and volunteer and part-time. So we want to go with standardization. So we've went a smaller here container, and that'll have a place for everything, and that helps us speed out checkouts or checkoffs in the morning, so that when we're getting ready to go. One thing interesting right here, this is the first truck that my understanding that Pierce has done, that Whelan has done, with those new scene lights right there, that we are very impressed with being able to have on that and be the first to build that. We have a great partnership with Wheeling, where we do, we got the Wheeling Cloud that we'll use, that we can track our speed of our fire trucks. It also, we do traffic preemption work right there, so this is all loaded in there to be able to make that happen. So this is actually where we're, I want our trucks to not have any wasted space. So this is my truck committee supporting our my objectives, and this is where they're gonna store the air pack for the driver out there, because we cut down the seats to make that cab more functional. We're able to have this to use that. So again, no used to lost space in this apparatus is one thing I'm really, in a very compact, user-friendly packaging. You can see right here's the winch that we use a lot, you know, for stabilization of those vehicles, or, you know, helping our people get up and down the roadways off the side of the mountains. So one of the unique challenges that are new for us in Pigeon Forge, because we cover 12 square miles inside the city, which is pretty well urban, all right, but then and suburban, but then we also have those theme parks, but we also have a large area of the county that we cover. So this truck is going to be set up to have hard suction. That's a first for us, is to be able to have this ability to be able to do hard suction. And our thought is, if something happens to the water system or something happens and we don't have water capabilities, this is going to be that ability to be able to take care of that. We do have the hose bed cover. We really like how that works. The traffic advisors, this has got the cameras where we can see going backwards and forwards. And then, of course, it's got that cover is going to be up there. It's just not up there right now. Again, another area right here for another secure point. When we try to think about the ergonomics of getting our firefighters safely up there on the top and back down the bottom, but again, another secure point for those winches and ropes that we're going to use. This is a new thing for us right here that we did in Pigeon Forge, because we try to work closely with Pierce and think about what's happening in the fire service, how can we make it better, we want to improve on each process. So again, this is where we store our oil dry in the accidents right here, and that takes it somewhere again to keep it where we need it and out of the way, but stored in the right person. Again, because we're doing a lot of rescues, one of the things I forgot to tell you up there, we have full dunnage compartments up there that is able to help support, you know, we may have our water rescue equipment up there, we may have some of our rope equipment up there, we got some of our wildland packs may be stored up there, because again, we're doing like everybody, doing a million different things. We're all about fire safety, so Magna Grip's what we're using right there to be able to do direct exhaust protection. Some of the things that we think are unique here is we want our officer to have a really good situational awareness what we're going, so they have the control for the mechanical siren, the air horn, but then more importantly, they have that speedometer where they can see about the speed. And again, our city has supported us with the side airbags and stuff like that that keeps our firefighters safe. You know, this is really what we talk about. Everybody goes home, but then our crowded parkway, we want to be able to make sure that we've got the lighting there to be able to push that traffic away, because as we well know, you know, we're getting firefighters hit on the roadways all too frequently. About the public safety is that we want to be able to see. This is a blind spot normally, but that gives us the ability. You got a big screen in there that we can see when we're turning on. So that's huge for us right there, that camera, and the commitment to that. One on the rear, one on the side, that helps us make good calls. Hey, thank you for all watching this right here. If you've got any questions, we'd love to work with you and give you, because we're all in this together. But I can't say enough for Pigeon Forge Fire Department, our city commission, City Pigeon Forge, working with Pierce, working with Sid Martins and our sales. This is really a team thing right there. Just so thank you all for paying attention, and thank you for making a difference.